Hi friends, GT Coding here. In this tutorial, we are going to learn about arrays. So array is basically a data structure to store similar type of data in a contiguous memory location. Array is a linear data structure. A linear data structure means that all the items in the data structure are arranged sequentially. There are two ways in which we can do this. We can, of course, store the items sequentially in the memory itself. For example, if we store an item on the memory location 200, we can store the next item on the memory location 201. The next approach that we can use to arrange items sequentially is by using a pointer to point to the next item. So one thing to remember in arrays is that computer doesn't track all the addresses of all the indices in the array, but it just remembers the base address of the array or the address of the first index of the array. All the other addresses of the indices can be calculated by using the base address. Now we will see why we need an array. Suppose we want to write a program to store the attendance of all the students in a class. Suppose there are 100 students, then what we can do is create a variable for the first student named A1 and store his attendance, and another variable named A2 and store the attendance of the next student, and in this way do this for 100 students. And this can be frustrating and complicated as well. So to make things easier and simpler and compact, we use arrays. So to create an array, you have to first write the data type name. Here we are storing integers, so we will write int, then the name of the array, and in square brackets you have to write how many items are there in the array. Now to store items in the array, you can write all the values in curly braces like this. So this 100 here means that there are 100 items in the array. We have to remember that array starts from index 0, and so this range will be 0 to 99. So if we want to print the first item in the array, we can write something like print A0, which prints the first item of the array, that is 75. So this is how we create and initialize an array. So now we will look at what are the types of arrays. There are two types of arrays: single dimensional arrays and multidimensional arrays. So single dimensional arrays are simple arrays, the one that we just created. So for example, if we create an array int A3, we can see that the memory from 104 to 115 are allocated by the RAM for this array. We are having multiples of 4 because we are creating the array of integers, and an integer has a size of 4 bytes. We can fill in values in the array by writing the following code, and it will be stored in the memory. The next type of array is multidimensional arrays. So multidimensional arrays can be thought of as arrays inside another array. So in this example, we can see that the 2 represents the first dimension and the 3 represents the second dimension. So it basically means that there are 2 blocks of memory, and in each block of memory there are 3 sub-blocks. So in this example, we can see that there are 6 blocks of memory allocated for this array. And so broadly, there are 2 blocks in which each block contains 3 sub-blocks. So we can fill in some values in the array and it gets filled into the memory. These three items form one part of the first dimension and the next three items form the next part of the first dimension, and all these individual parts are items of the second dimension. So this is how a multidimensional array can be created. You can also create multidimensional arrays with more than two dimensions. Now we will look at some of the operations of array. So first operation is insert. To insert an item in the array at a specific location, we have to create room for it at that location. So we have to shift all the items to the right. So we'll write a basic code to implement this insert operation. We'll write a for loop from I is equal to size to position, and we will decrement the value of I. That is, I starts from the last item in the array to the location that we want to insert, and we will shift all these items to the right. Now we have created room for inserting the item. Now we can just write a position and initialize it with the item. And we have to also increment the size variable, which is the size of the array, and the array size increases by 1 when we insert one element in the array. So this is how we insert an element in the array. So here in this example, we want to insert 23 into the location 3. So we have to shift all the items after that position to the right. So the next operation that we are going to see is append operation. So append is basically adding or inserting an item at the end of the array. So here we have an array of elements up to 4, and we have the 7th index free. So we can append 100 to the 7th index, and it goes on here. To write the code for append, you can simply write a and a size, where size is the size of the array, and initialize it to item, and of course increment the size, and that's all. So append is a fairly easy operation. So the next operation that we will see is delete. So we want to delete the item at position 5. So what we do is delete that item and shift all the items after that position to the left. We write the code as follows. So we will loop from position to size minus 1 and initialize ai to ai plus 1. This will shift all the elements to the left, and of course we have to decrement the value of size, because after deleting one item, the size of our array decreases by 1. Here we can see that we have shifted both the items 4 and 100 to the left. And this is how we perform the delete operation. The next operation is search. So in this example, we want to search the item 8 in the array. So we start from 0th index and check whether it is equal to the value of the first index. We can see that value of the first index is 5 and it is not equal to 8. So we'll go and check the next index, and it is not equal to 4, and we will go and check the next index, index number 2, and we can see that 8 is equal to 8, and we have found the search term or the search item. Now we have found the item and we can return the position of the item. So to write the code for this operation, we first loop from 0 to size, and if you find that the ith item in the array is equal to the search term or the search item, then what we do is break from the loop, and here we will write an if condition to check if we have found the item or not. If I is equal to size, printf not found, or else you can print out found at the location I. Now we will quickly see what are the pros and cons of arrays. So the first advantage of array is that it is easy to implement. You have to just write the data type name and the name of the array and is equal to curly braces and put the values. That's all you need to create an array. The next advantage is that it is faster to access. So if you want to access the third index of the array, you can directly write A3 and that gets the value of the third index of the array. Some of the disadvantages of array are arrays are fixed in size. So when we create the array, at that time we have to specify how many items we want in the array. So in the example here, we cannot write A8 is equal to 32 because we have predetermined the size of the array to 7. The next disadvantage is that there is a lot of wastage of memory if we fix the size of the array to something large. So here the indices from 2 to 7 are wasted. And the next disadvantage that we find in array is that to insert or delete items in the array, you have to shift some items to the left or right. So in the worst case, you have to shift all the items to the left or right. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope you have understood how array works and what are the properties of arrays and what are the operations of arrays. Thank you for watching.